Hello and welcome to Jams. Welcome back to Hoth. Welcome back to the Jedi Academy playthrough and Echo Base. So the Imperials have got in through using the remains of an Atsa, which was left over from the original attack. They've kind of hid in there and drilled down and eventually found their way inside Echo Base. All of this without the Republic and, you know, Luke noticing. You think they keep track of their old fortresses just in case the Imperials did take them, because if you remember, it actually took a bit of effort to get in here. And they had these, you know, they had the walkers and all sorts. So you think it'd be something that the rebels would know quite well to keep an eye on, something as defensible as this. But you know, I'm not going to question it. It's a nice little addition to the game, something which links it with the movies quite well, so keeps the fans engaged. And personally, I like the if you watched the last video, you'll have seen the Wampers. I enjoy that. That's a thing. Come on, die. I enjoy that. That's a thing. He says, "What has happened to him?" I quite like that they pick you up and then you chop their arm off, and then that's how you kill them rather than. Yeah, just they could have invented a location and had gun darks, or you know, have just invented something that had absolutely nothing to do with the movies, and yeah, whatever. I like that they've gone through the effort to include this in the storyline to make this a playable level. There is somewhere to go here. No. Come on. Is it one of these, maybe? Nah. The big, obvious lift thing. Great. That just made me look a little stupid. A lot of checkpoints. Not really sure I need them. That's just a big circle. What's over here? See what I mean about how long it takes the stormtroopers to turn those around? I mentioned it in the last video that it just takes years for the stormtroopers to walk those turrets around, but when we get on them, it flicks around really quickly, almost as fast as the camera does without you manning a turret. So, I mean, it's nice. It means the turrets are actually usable. I just, you know, think it should just be one mechanic for everybody. That would make it fairer. And it would make the game harder, which, you know, is a bonus. Because at this point, I mean, you see how quickly I'm just taking these guys out. Just, it's a sidestep the blaster bolt, one swipe and they're dead. Which, I mean, you know, fair enough, is exactly what it would be like if I was actually having a proper lightsaber and stabbing stormtroopers with it. But it does, I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't want this to be like a Dark Souls game where it's just so hard it's impossible. And it's quite nice that these die really easily, because it's really satisfying to just wander around and just slice things. It's one of the things that makes this game something that I keep coming back to, and something which, when I saw it on the Humble Bundle, went, you know, I've got to get this. Because my old copy of this just doesn't work anymore. Alright then, so Command Center to Allura. Allura here. We've just finished downloading the data. The rebels must have erased everything during the evacuation. Fortunately, some more exposition. So that isn't good. He's kind of, oh dear. Okay, so when this happens and they knock it out of your hand, you press the attack button again and you call it to your hand in the same way that Luke did when he was hanging upside down with the Wampa. I like, this is the other thing I like in this game. You see how you've got the lightsaber that illuminates these areas. It's quite nice. So my mission's been updated. Discover what the Imperials are doing in Echo Base. We found out what the Imperials are doing in Echo Base. Now what? Oh. Oh, okay. Sod. Off. How many hits does this thing take? Come on. There we go. Right in the dick with a lightsaber. It's a bad way to go. That is a bad way to go. So I think we're coming up on a boss fight. It's usually why there is checkpoints and all this stuff here. Yep! There's a boss fight. Alrighty then.
Well done, my apprentice. Meet me there. Ah, you must be the saber-wielding troublemaker who neutralized our perimeter guard.
Yep, sure. Whatever. You know what? I'm just gonna come over there and I'm just gonna stab you right in the chest. Of which you'll notice, being a female Twi'lek thing, she has a chest. So these fights are best completed just either like I'm doing now, just slowly chip away at her. Not a fan of these lag spikes. Okay, that worked. Yeah, the other option is to use your four speed powers and then just walk up and just keep hitting her. But that seemed to work quite quickly.
I can't wait.
Okay. Yay! So we made it home. That was the first boss of the game. Luke has very, very pointy elbows, and he does that whole staring into space thing quite a lot. Okay then, so I'm going to end this video here, and I will see you again next time. Bye!